Okay, so today the topic is fine-tuning. Now, previously we learned about transfer learning, where we just changed the classification stage and retained the information that we had in the feature extractor stage. So with fine-tuning, we first change the last layer to match the classes in our dataset, as we have done before in the transfer learning. But we also retrain the layers of the network that we want. So we just don't have to change the classification stage. We can also change the feature extractor stage, where we have all the convolutional and all the pooling layers. So remember, we talked about the VGG 16 architecture. So in transfer learning, we changed only the layers of the classification stage and kept all the knowledge that the network obtained when extracting the features and characteristics when we were loading the weights of the ImageNet. So with fine tuning, we are not limited to that. We do not need to retrain only the classifier stage. We can retrain also the feature extraction stage, that is the convolutional and all the pooling layers. Now, it's important to keep in mind that in a neural network, the first layers detect simpler and more general patterns. And the more we advance in the architecture, it can detect more specific to the dataset and more complicated patterns. Therefore, we would allow the last block of the convolution and the pooling layers to be retrained. Okay, so now the question arises that when should I do fine tuning or transfer learning, and how can I know that which layer to retrain it from? Well, as a general rule, the first thing we will do is transfer learning, because we will not retrain our network. This will give us a baseline that we will have to overcome now. Then we can retrain only the classification stage, and after that we can try to retrain some of the convolutional block as well. So it depends on the type of problem you have. So let's say if we have a new dataset and we have a small dataset and it is similar to the original one, then we should be a bit careful when fine tuning, because then maybe it is better to choose the characteristics of the last layer of the convolutional stage and just use an SVM or a linear classifier on that. And the second scenario can be when the new dataset is large and similar to the original. So now we have more data, so we probably won't overfit, and we can use fine tuning with more confidence here. Now, what if the new dataset is small and very different from the original? Then it would be best to use the features of earlier layer of the convolutional stage, as this will be set in more general patterns than the later layers, and then we can use a linear classifier on that. And the last scenario can be where we have a new dataset and it's big and very different from the original one on which the model is already trained. So in this case, we will train it from scratch. However, it is still recommended that you initialize the weights with those of the model that it was already trained on, which in our case is ImageNet. One more thing to note when we are practically implementing it is that we have to take account of the possible restrictions of the pre-trained models. For example, they can have a minimum image size that they require. And also, when we are retraining the networks, we usually choose lower learning rates than if we do it from the scratch, since we are initializing the weights that are already assumed to be good, meaning that the model is closer to its convergence. So this was all from the fine-tuning lecture, and these are some of the references that I've taken the slides from, and you can also go check them out for a more detailed explanation.